Can you share your insight into how not to make addiction out of meditation?
How not to make the addiction of meditation is, this is something really you should understand. For that, we have to understand all the actions we are doing throughout the day, from morning to night. So many types of karmas we are performing, and every action we do, remember, have a limit. Eating, sleeping, speaking, listening, sitting, walking, running, you look around, all the action have ing in English in the end. And in Hindi we say na. Na word is after all the actions, after all the verbs, like chalna, khana, peena, dorna, sunna, tairna, dubna, every word have na in the end. It means every action has a limit. But what is after yoga? There is a word, it's called yoga abhyas. It means yoga practice. Practice yoga. There is no ing, there is no na in the end. So yoga has no limit. More you practice, more you get the bliss. This is different from the actions you perform throughout the day, because those actions have materialistic performance. When you perform those actions, you will get something in return, or there is some give and take. But when you practice yoga, this is something where you spend your energy for yourself. So that make a lot of difference. That make a lot of sense for yourself, that this is kind of investment of energy in yourself. When you invest your energy in yourself, that little positive energy become thousandfold, and then you'll feel that energy around you and in your mind. That's how we can differentiate. Meditation is not the addiction. If this is become addiction for you are the luckiest person on earth, and I hope this become addiction for you. Thank you so much.
Can you give us advice how to heal broken heart?
How to heal the broken heart, or how to deal with a failed relationship? You have to understand few things about being in a relationship. The one thing is that when you break up, when you get separate from someone, it means your energy is not the same. You must be having the different energy. That's why you decided to get separate. And if you understand the concept of energy, it will be very easy for you to understand, like all the friends you make. Sometime with the parents, even with the family, you don't have that good relationship. It's not because you don't have love, it's not because you don't have care. It is because the flow of the energy is different. And when energy flows in different directions, it's very difficult to keep yourself in a relationship with someone. Second thing you have to understand about the failed relationship is, because when you are not happy with someone, then only you decide to get separate, right? And if somebody is not happy with you, and if somebody is not feeling happy, or you are not happy with someone, would you really like to live with that person? I think you will find your own happiness and you will find your own way. If you really care about your happiness and freedom, then you will find your own way to find the peace and the bliss in your mind and your heart. So, two things where we can say here. One is the different energy flow, and second thing is happiness. If you don't feel happy with somebody, I would suggest just go and find your own way, and the happiness will find you. If you respect yourself, nature will respect you too. Thank you.
How perception of the world can be changed by practicing yoga or meditation?
You use the words and you use the different languages. Maybe you speak Spanish, French, German, Italian, Chinese, Russian, or English, or Hindi. You use some certain words in the form of some vibration to pass your message from one to another person. That's how the language works. That's how the word works. And also, the amount of stress you are giving to every word, it can be different and it can bring the different outcome, different meaning of the words. But remember, this rule works only with the language, with a spoken language. What if we have no ability to speak and no ability to listen? We can go for the language of silence. That language of silence is much more deeper than any other spoken language. For spoken language, you need to learn some certain rule of the language. You speak with the elder, how do you need to speak? You speak with the younger people, how do you need to, how polite you need to be, and some grammars and some other stuff. But when you speak or when you practice the language of silence, those rules are different. Then you really understand the meaning of being silence. And after some time, when you spend some time in silence and when you come in spoken language, your words will be having deep influence and the deep meaning. Whatever you will say, people will listen to you. And when you order something, when you ask some people to do something for you, they will do. They have to do it, because it will become more influential then. Because that will be carrying the power of silence. Words carrying the power of silence. See how amazing it is. You are speaking the words, but it is coming from the power of silence. So you have to gain, you have to get that silence within you. It's not about the oral silence only. When you stay silent and when you stay with the nature for a long time and when you practice meditation and you go deep inside, that gives you opportunity to be with yourself, and that will generate the amazing energy from you, and that will be the beautiful influence you can put in any language, in any words. Thank you.